Last summer, we at Absolute Radio announced the launch of the Absolute Radio account, and today I'd like to share with you the reasons for that launch and why we think asking listeners to log in and listen points to the future of commercial radio. In November last year, research conducted by Sociable Labs indicated that half of all visitors to e-commerce sites were logged into Facebook at that very moment. A month later, an EA announced that only a week after the launch of its game Star Wars: The Old Republic, over 60 million logged-in hours had been clocked by their online gamers, which EA could in turn use to understand gaming preferences, such as whether a user preferred to play as a Sith or a Jedi, very important in the gaming world. Whether it's social media, gaming, retail, or banking, our online lives continue to be influenced by information mined from registration data and logged-in behavior. And it's this data which will form the foundation of any media brand hoping to support its future business through an ad-funded model. One music brand that's been particularly good at using logged-in information for mutual consumer and commercial benefit is Pandora. If you're not aware of Pandora, Pandora is a US automated music recommendation platform that improves future song selection based on positive or negative user feedback. When it launched on the New York Stock Exchange in June last year, it was valued at $2.6 billion. And since then, it's gone to grow to account for over 4% of total US listening. So why was Pandora valued so highly? Well, I think it can be attributed to three things. Pandora took advantage of the boom in smartphone adoption by readying apps across all the major mobile operating systems. Since then, they've seen their mobile listening grow from 4.6% in 2009 to over 70% last year. Secondly, audience. Pandora knew that being able to target someone based on their age or gender was of more value to an advertiser than a generic audience. And although, like Spotify, they have a subscription business model, in the 3 months leading up to November 2011, advertising comprised 88% of their total revenues. And being able to target by demographic was key to that. And lastly, Pandora is interactive. They built web-based and social interactivity around their core listen proposition to enhance the consumer experience and the opportunities for advertisers. Of course, Pandora isn't broadcast. When you join a Pandora stream, you're listening to your own personalized music preferences. When you join a radio stream, you are part of a shared listening community. So the challenge for radio has been, how can it take the one-to-one benefits of streaming services like Pandora and combine it with a one-to-many model of broadcast radio? How can it do this? Well, if we address the issue of access first. Any brand connected to their IP audience can access their location data. Absolute Radio, you can see here, we can access total active sessions in real time at any given moment across the whole world. And this is a snapshot of Christian's show the other day in London and the Southeast. And at each data point, we can ascertain session length, device, and the particular app that someone is using. But we don't just have to do it for total sessions. We can also isolate specific apps, like the Live Score app, so we can understand consumption patterns on match day, such as the Arsenal versus Bolton game at the Emirates Stadium, or the Manchester Derby, which ended particularly badly for United, I remember that day. Being able to target users based on active location is incredibly important. But if radio is to truly realize the ambitions of brands like Pandora, then it also needs to address the issue of audience. It needs to be able to target by demographic. In the case of what we're doing at Absolute Radio, this led to the formation of the Absolute Radio account. On the right there, it lists a series of benefits for the user to incentivize them to share their information with us. Higher quality audio, less ads, so typically you might receive only 2 ads in an ad break instead of a possible 6, and real-world rewards. When we launched this in the summer, we set a public benchmark of 100,000 registrations by the end of the year. And I'm pleased today to be able to tell you that by December the 31st, we'd achieved 108,000 registrations. Since then, we've rolled that out onto mobile. And in that time, we've seen registrations, weekly registrations on mobile, surpass that of desktop. Last week, we had 13,000 new registrations. 10,000 of those alone were from the iPhone. This is in part due to a series of new installations, app installations over Christmas. In December, we had 505,000 new installations and updates, which led to our highest ever weekly active mobile figure of 124,000 mobile users. So when we have these people logged in, registered, what happens next? Well, we term these people smart streamers. And it's to these smart streamers that we can start to deliver a bespoke ad log. And I'll show you how this works now. Here we go. So they log in and they join the Absolute Radio content stream. They're listening to the same stream. The stream is in sync as the non-logged in dumb stream. In a moment, you'll hear the ad break. This is the point where the smart stream and the non-logged in dumb stream split from each other. And the smart streamer will hear an ad tailored to their specific demographic and location information. At the same time, the audio ad will trigger a bespoke interactive visual for the user to engage with.
Open your radio player window now for more information on the following message.
Hey, Kylie.
Shh.
Sorry. Now you've joined the quiet revolution. Have you seen the new F-Sport Lexus CT200H?
Shh.
Dark alloy wheels, bold mesh sports grille and spoiler.
Shh.
The world's first full hybrid luxury compact car with low emissions and excellent fuel efficiency and all the quality, refinement and driving pleasure you'd expect from Lexus.
The new F-Sport Lexus CT200H. Join the quiet revolution.
Click the banner now to explore the car.
We call this in-stream advertising. And after a listener has heard typically two 30-second spots, they would then hear up to 2 minutes of exclusive content while that stream waits for the non-logged-in extended ad log on the dumb stream to finish, at which points those two streams will converge and will again be completely in sync until the next ad break. The future of in-stream isn't just about targeted messaging on desktop or mobile. It's about targeted messaging on any web-connected smart device, such as IPTV, where the internet, through allowing listeners to log in and listen, begins to redefine radio. In-stream finally allows for a one-to-one advertising stream to be brought together with a one-to-many broadcast radio stream, ensuring that a traditional medium can continue to thrive in a digital age. Thank you. I feel like Westlife up here.
Do you think unless commercial radio finds a business model that is based on personalized advertising, it shrivels and dies?
No. I mean, at the moment, and I suppose this could be linked, we get a lot of questions about whether in-stream is going to replace airtime, and the fact is absolutely not. I mean, just from a business point of view, airtime still accounts for the lion's share of our business, and from a brand's perspective, it remains an incredibly important vehicle to deliver a message to a wide audience. I think if we're asking about is in-stream going to somehow threaten airtime, then that's actually a misconception of what the two things are. Airtime is all about scale, mass reach. In-stream is all about targeting. And it's not meant to replace airtime, they're meant to complement each other. It's very similar, actually, compared to, I think, when VOD and pre-roll first emerged into the market, a lot of TV buyers were saying, is pre-roll going to cannibalize TV airtime? And time has shown that actually that's completely not the case, and both from a content and a commercial perspective, those two have complemented each other, and Thinkbox have done numerous studies on it. And that's exactly the same as what I think will happen here. In-stream isn't meant to replace airtime, it's meant to enhance it. And actually, just while I made Target Spot, a company in the US, they've just conducted a bit of research where they looked at adding a targeted digital audio ad to an existing airtime campaign. And they actually found that doing that increased response rates by 3.5 times. So the two are there to support each other.
Great, thank you. James Wigley.
All right, thank you.